Welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Shane, and in today's video, we're going to be talking about how to double your income like Warren Buffett. So two books where I got my information from is The Intelligent Investor. I read this book a few years ago, and let me tell you, if you are having a difficult time sleeping, this is the book for you. There's a lot of good information in it. And I needed to buy this book because I wanted to know how this guy thinks, because Benjamin Graham was Warren Buffett's mentor. And this is another fantastic read, The Warren Buffett Way. It's a little bit better than Intelligent Investor. In fact, goes into detail as to how he started Berkshire and Hathaway. How it was a textile business, and then how he converted it over to the company it is today, how he thinks about investing in stocks. So today, I'm going to keep it real simple, real light. We're just going to pretend we're going into a time machine, and we're going to go all the way back to March of 2020. That's right, 2020, when the pandemic hit us. So just over 2 years ago. So I'm going to share the prices of what some of the stocks were. And these are some of the stocks that I purchased. And at the end of the video, I'm going to talk about one stock that I missed. Totally struck out. I wish I bought some. It's never too late. But I'm going to let you know about that stock and what it's trading today. So the first one, let's just go to share my screen. Tried using the whiteboard. Man, was that difficult. For some reason, just difficult. Couldn't get the audio, all kinds of stuff. Just crazy things would happen with it. So we're going to go here. We're going to try and keep it real simple. So the first stock I'm going to be talking about is Nike. And this was 2020. So if you like this kind of thing, subscribe to this channel. If you like Warren Buffett, all this kind of stuff, feel free to comment. Let me know if you purchased any of these stocks or if this is an interest to you. I am not a stockbroker. These are just some of the stocks that I purchased back in 2019 because I wanted to get into the whole investing, and I was able to open up an account with my RBC account. And these are some of the stocks I bought. So the first one was Nike. And in March of 2020, it was trading at $67. Today, it's trading at $107. If you had bought this stock 5 years ago, you would have a gain of 99%. Isn't that ridiculous? So 5 years ago, it was lower than 67. The next stock we're going to be talking about is Amex. I like these guys. Never used to like them, but have much respect for them. American Express, they were $74. Today, they're trading at $159. And if you bought these guys 5 years ago, you would have gains of 100%. Isn't that ridiculous? Like, how easy is this? Just put some money aside. Like, I created an RRSP account, so it's a tax-free savings account. So any money that you put into it does not get taxed, which is pretty cool. It actually reduces your taxable income. The next one I'm going to be talking about is Apple. At least that's how it's set up in Canada. I'm not sure how you're IROTH, IRAs, or whatever they are. I'm not sure how it works in America, but we can still buy American stock, which is cool. So Apple dipped down to $60. And today is trading at $146. So if you bought Apple 5 years ago, you would have a gain of 275%. That's not 225. That's 275%. Ridiculous. Disney. I'm not a fan of Disney. I never bought any stocks in Disney, and I probably never will. don't like the company. Maybe I'll share my reasons in another video. I think they've made too many mistakes over the past few years. Never liked them ever since the documentary on Lemmings, when Walt Disney was ushering lemmings over a cliff and making these lemmings jump off a cliff and killing themselves. And everybody to this day thinks that lemmings commit suicide every year, but no, it's because Walt Disney was filming a documentary and pushed them all off of a cliff. Look it up. Anyways, never liked them since then. Didn't really treat animals very nice. So 105, if you bought Disney 5 years ago, you would be down 5%. You would have lost money in 5 years. Or some cases, depending who you are, you might think, oh, it's on sale right now. Procter & Gamble. Hope you like this kind of thing. If you do, let me know in the comments. I like talking about this stuff. If you bought Procter & Gamble in 2020, today it would be worth $152. So I bought some Procter & Gamble as well. The crazy part is if you trade it, you don't have it anymore. So if you buy a whole bunch of stock, if you go off of Warren Buffett's methodology, he doesn't sell anything, nothing. It's like living in a home. We bought a nice home. In 2 years, our home went up over $60,000. But if I sold this home, I got to live somewhere. So it's kind of a weird thing to think about. Capital One. So Procter & Gamble, if you bought it 5 years ago, you would have gained 77%. We're not talking 10, 15%, guys. These are huge, 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 huge gains. So let me erase these. I just have a few more stocks to share, but these are just basic stocks, man. These are things that are tangible, that people buy products every single day. People are buying Apple computers, Apple phones, smartwatches, iPhones, all those kinds of stuff every single day. So I'm not sure if I did Capital One. I think I did not. So Capital One is another one of my favorite companies. They've always treated me pretty good. I have a bunch of credit cards through them. They actually helped me build my credit back up to a place where I can actually purchase this home. Thanks, Capital One. This is not sponsored by Capital One, but maybe it should be. So 119. So this is how much you could sell their stock for today or buy it today. So if you bought it 2 years ago, $45, not a bad deal. If you bought this stuff 5 years ago, you would have made 50%. So it would have been a little bit less, or around the, probably around the same range 5 years ago. Visa. This is Warren Buffett's favorite one. This guy made a huge play when he first started into the game of buying stocks. He waited till Visa was basically on their knees, and he purchased a ton of Visa, a ton. I think it was Visa, might have been Amex, but I'm pretty sure it was Visa. So what had happened was when Visa, well, there was another company, American Express, when they were going down in the tank, Warren Buffett decided to buy some stock anyways, because what he noticed is when he went into a grocery store, people were still buying stuff on credit cards. So that told him he needed to invest in credit card companies. And ultimately he bought Geico, an insurance company, because that was cash flow for him so that he could open up other, that he could purchase other companies and take them over. So let's see here. So Visa, so if you bought Visa 5 years ago, you'd be up 112%. So we talk about this stuff in my mastermind group. If you ever want to register for it, you just have to go to doublemyincomesociety.com/mastermind. It's free until June. You can join us. All you have to do is just leave your name, email address, all that good stuff. I will not charge you a nickel for a mastermind group starting May 19th. And you'll be able to participate in three classes, 3 sessions, 3 masterminds. We do it every other week for 3 weeks. At the end of those 3 weeks, which is basically at the end, the beginning of June, I might extend it to July, but right now it's till June. If you decided in June or July that you liked the mastermind group, then we can talk about purchasing a monthly membership, which I believe will be at $47 a month. But right now it's absolutely free for you to try it out, check us out, hang around, all that good stuff. So let's continue on. So we got Visa, we got CN Rail. If you guys like railways, you can pick other railway companies from the States. Of course, Warren Buffett owns a bunch of railway companies. If you bought CN Rail today, $144. And that is a gain of 42%. Not in the last 2 years. This is, you would have gained 42% over the past 5 years. So I'm kind of giving you two numbers. I'm giving you what was purchased in 2020 and then what the price is today. And then I'm also giving you a percentage over the past 5 years, because I think that's important as well. So let's just skip to Amazon. A lot of people like Amazon. Amazon's an interesting company. If you bought their stocks in 2020, you can sell them now for $2,007, $2,107. Over 5 years, you would have 119% gain. The interesting thing about Amazon is I don't think they lost a nickel. They're probably the only company where their stock continued to rise. What else? Costco. A lot of people like Costco. I like Costco. I shop there quite a bit. Used to have a Costco credit card, but CIBC won that contract. So now Costco uses CIBC. So just automatically your Capital One credit card converts over to a CIBC credit card, which you'll probably get in 2024 off the top of my head. I know this because I have like 14 or 15 credit cards. Anyways, so what did we do? Costco? Not sure if we did. Let me just do Costco real quick here. I have a good memory. It's just short. So if you bought Costco, $290 today, it's at $489. And if you bought it 5 years ago, you would be up 186%. This is, my friends, this is how you double your income, like Warren Buffett. Netflix, another company I do not like. I use them, I subscribe to them, have subscribed to them ever since Blockbuster went under, but I'm thinking on canceling my membership. I really am. I don't like their programs. It's boring. It's boring TV. So $368. Today it's trading at $166. So if you were to sell today, you would lose some serious cashola. Gain of 3% over 5 years. They're hurting. They're hurting. We just don't see it yet. But they're a hurting company. Another one, Starbucks. A lot of people like this company. I like them. I buy Starbucks every weekend. I like my Starbuckses. $58 2 years ago. Today, $70. Respectable. Gain of 16% over 5 years. So that's a little bit slower than all the other companies that I've talked about. And last but not least, I'm going to talk about one company where I did not purchase any stocks from them. And I kicked myself, man. I kicked myself because, man, if you could put like 2 years ago, just 2 years ago, if you had put $100,000 into this company, man, you'd be a millionaire today. Tesla. Why? It was 2 years ago in March of 2020, their stock dipped down to $85. And if you're just hanging around like Warren Buffett with a little bit of cashola in the bank account, today you could sell your stock for $734 US. Isn't that insane? You could buy one stock, two stocks, 100 stock, 1,000 stock, whatever. If you bought Tesla five years ago, you would be up 1,000 freaking percent. Isn't that ridiculous? I could have bought Tesla at $85. I wasn't sure what was going on with this whole pandemic, and I totally missed Tesla. I was keeping an eye on it, but I didn't buy any. None, zero. And $734, I'm going to buy it today at $734. It's probably going to go up to $1,000. That would be my guess. So what do you think? Is this a way that you like doubling your income? I think this is a great, honest way of doubling your income just by investing in American companies, Canadian companies, and just hold. Just buy them and hold, especially when you see little things like Russia invading Ukraine and then the stocks start to take a dip. That's when you buy. And then, like, let's just say, for example, in the fall, if things happen again where there's a 60th wave or whatever going on and the stocks start going down, what I would do is just write all the stock prices right now. There's apps for that. And just keep track and just say, you know what? If Tesla went down to $200, that's a steal. Even $500 would be a steal right now. But right now it's a little high for me, personally, me. So if I bought Apple today, I think it's still a decent deal because it was hovering around $300, but for some reason it's $146. You still make money on that. Disney, I don't know what's going on with them. You're losing money if you invest in Disney. It's kind of weird, but yeah. Anyways, there's my 2 cents. So hopefully you like this kind of thing. This is just another way to double your income, and it's easier than you think. I wish I knew this stuff years ago. I'd be way farther ahead than where I'm at right now. Just a simple philosophy. Pick a couple of companies that you like, that you understand a little bit about how they work, especially if you see people buying stuff from Costco all the time, even in a pandemic. It's not a bad company to purchase. Railway companies, not bad companies to purchase. Warren Buffett owns a few railway companies. So there you go. That's my 2 cents. I know it's a bit of a long video, but if you like this type of thing, subscribe to this YouTube channel. Let me know in the comments, and I will see you in another video. Bye for now.